they have been in indirect contact since the 1950s through Peter Clarke's reading of and strong identification with George Lanning's work. Professor Gladstone Yearwood, the director of the Errol Barrow Centre for Creative Imagination, responded with faith and determination to the possibilities of this contact, and he is primarily responsible for the exhibition's manifestation. We thank him profoundly and acknowledge his courage and creative vision, which made contact between our two countries possible. It is clear that we can, although we might still have to fly via the first world to reach each other, build initiatives where sharing knowledge and mutual understanding enrich our lives. We have a huge historical legacy of division to overcome, but initiatives like this give concrete expression to Ubuntu's guiding concepts and proverbs, Ubuntu, Ubuntu, and Gavangi, Ubuntu. A person is a person by and because of other people. This proverb is well known in different forms throughout Africa and could be regarded as a basis of African humanism based on collective spirituality. We are more than privileged to have this collaboration with the Errol Barrow Centre for the Creative Imagination, which concretizes links between our two similar societies. At the Errol Barrow Centre and in Barbados in general, we have been privileged to work with three professionals with great souls: Francis Hines Rufus, Nareen Drudder, who curated the exhibition, and Sharka Rugby. Again, a possible connection across the Atlantic Ocean manifests in Sharka's life story. His father, Walter, who worked in East Africa, is a legendary and inspiring figure for us. Another thanks to Avocado Accent for photos and invitation design, and to Rodney Ickle for his assistance with the photo session, as well as his passionate appreciation of the art. He gave us a foretaste of Barbados' massive Ubuntu, which was very encouraging. Paula Mascol and her team for exhibiting incredible professionalism and grace under pressure. Brian Alcock, as you mentioned, especially for his late hours completing the catalogue and Lorraine Lashley for tagging the labels. There's some people across the Atlantic Ocean whose faces you won't see, but I'd like to mention them. Josephine Fraser, one of the Art and Ubuntu trustees, who participated in the selection of the works in Cape Town over a number of Cape Town Summer Sundays, always gives generously of herself to Art and Ubuntu projects. And Khadija Badat is keeping the home fire burning in our office in Cape Town. Together they are keeping contact with Peter Clarke as things proceed here. When the possibility of the exhibition emerged, he said, "I am terribly excited and he would love to be with us and he's with us in spirit tonight." So last but not least, we thank the artist Peter Clarke for his thoughtfulness, humility and genius, and for the privilege of being able to show work spanning six decades of his life, which powerfully led on to society. And I now have a statement to read from Peter Clarke, and I'm really moved and privileged to be his emissary here in Barbados.